Hello, I'm Ilyan St. Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to talk about MongoDB and how it runs with MeshCentral. We're going to talk about the benefits like peering, bulk operations, and also the free analytics that's offered by MongoDB. When you get started with MeshCentral, the built-in database that's used is called NeDB, and that is good for just getting started and for having a few machines. But as you go to a production environment or you increase the load on your server, you really want to change to a database that's a little bit more professional. And one of the best choices is MongoDB for MeshCentral. So we're going to take a look at, first of all, what are the options and what are the benefits and some of the things here to consider if you switch to MongoDB. So MeshCentral supports five different database types in the back end. And the real benefit of having such a diverse support for databases is that if you already have one of these databases deployed, if you already have MySQL deployed, for example, then you can just use that. You don't have to deploy another database in your back end. Now, if you don't have any database deployed, MongoDB is a really good option. But again, the default one is NeDB, and this is basically an in-memory database that is saved as a JSON file in basically a text file. So it's good for some things, but as you go to more professional usages, you want to switch from NeDB to one of these other databases. Now, if you are, just as a quick refresher, if you do want to switch from one database to another, so for example, if you are running NeDB, you'll have a config.json with settings that has no database parameters whatsoever, and so that's what you get started with. If you want to transition from NeDB to any other database, what you do is you run, first you'll have to stop the server, because obviously you don't want to have the server change the database while you're migrating. So you stop the server, and then you run MeshCentral-export, and you export your current database content into a file here, for example, bob.json. And then what you do is you go in the config.json file for MeshCentral, configure your database the way you want it, for example, here MongoDB with the URI, and then once it's done, you run MeshCentral again, -import and your file, and it will re-import that back into the new database. Now, export and import will not export all of the information. For example, power events and all the general events will not be exported, but the basics like the accounts, device groups, user groups, device information, and so on, that will be exported and re-imported into the next database. Okay, so that's how to migrate. And of course, there's if you're going to select MongoDB as your database, you can start with just saying MongoDB and URI in the settings. But as you progress and become more advanced, there's more advanced things you can do. For example, you can set up MongoDB with replica set, and so you would have a more advanced URI. There's also the change stream here that you can set to true, and we'll see what that does, and also bulk operations. You can set the true for a significant speed up, and so we'll see what that does. So let's just cover three topics that relate to MongoDB and MeshCentral. The first one is that MeshCentral works in peering only with MongoDB. So if you want to run multiple servers, like 2, 3, 4 MeshCentrals in parallel, and you want to offload the connections to the multiple servers, you will have to select MongoDB, and you will have to make MongoDB, the change stream of MongoDB, the replica set, turned on. So you'll have to have like an advanced installation of MongoDB, but once you have that installed, MeshCentral in peering mode works a little bit different than in standalone mode. In standalone mode, if you have a user and he's looking at different computers and he changes the name of a computer, then the MeshCentral server can update the database with a new name and immediately event to all the users that see that device the new name. So, for example, if a new device connects and so on, then MeshCentral, if it's standalone, can just event the information. But if it's in peering mode, what you want to do is kind of synchronize all the servers so that they're displaying to the users the same kind of information. So what we're going to do is we are going to take the change request or the connection or so on, we're going to save it in database. And Mongo will have a change stream that's like a stream of changes that have occurred on the database. And all of these servers will be subscribed to that change stream. So when a database reports that there's an update, for example, a device has changed name or a device connected or so on, then all the servers will receive that event from the database and propagate it to the users. So, for example, I'm going to use my trusty MeshCentral server here. Let's see. I am going to clear. Let's see. There it goes. So I have my demonstration server. And basically anything like, for example, just changing the name here. I'm going to add an X to this computer's name and click OK. And you see the X just showed up. Now, in standalone mode, you would issue a command to change the name, the server would receive the command, and then dispatch the name change to all the viewers, so all the different browsers. So let's suppose I'm gonna open another copy here. So if I change the name and say okay, you'll notice that that both browsers, the name has changed. But if you're standalone mode, that change occurs within the server. If you're in peering mode, then you change the name, it changes the database. The database reports back that a change has been made, and then all the peers and all the will take the change and propagate it from the database. So that's quite a difference between standalone and peering mode. And in order to synchronize all the servers, this is why it's important to have MongoDB change stream act this way. So that's one of the benefits of MongoDB. Now, another one, and this was implemented, starting with version 0.7.49 or something like that of MeshCentral. So all recent versions of MeshCentral should have this. There's a new way of writing data or deleting data from the MongoDB database, which is the bulk mode. So normally with SQL databases, with NeDB, with MongoDB normally, Postgres, SQL, and so on, what you do is you have a write operation, the database confirms, says, okay, I've written this thing, and then you execute another write, and you can pipeline a lot of writes, but for each write, you have an okay, basically, from the database. So with MongoDB, there's an operation called bulk write, and there's also bulk delete, where what you do is you group up all your writes and perform a single operation with all the writes in one shot. And then you get an okay for the entire bulk operation. So this I've seen this for 7,000 writes at once. Like literally, I would simulate 7,000 or 10,000 computers disconnecting from the server at once, and it would trigger, about 10,000 writes into the database to basically mark the disconnection of all the computers. Well, normally this is 10,000 round trips, but with bulk write enabled, I've seen a single operation with 7,000 writes in a single bulk for a single round trip. And what I've seen from a little bit of my testing is that with 10,000 computers disconnecting at once, you see a noticeable lag of a few seconds on the server. With bulk write, it's absolutely instant. You see nothing at all. It's so fast. So if you have a situation where you have a server that is quite loaded, performs lots of operations, then enabling bulk write is really the way to go. And you see it right here. It's called MongoDB bulk operations, and you set that to true. Now, right now, by default, it's set to false. At some point, I may actually make the default true, but I use it all the time, and it works great. Okay, so that's bulk operation. Reason number two for using MongoDB. Reason number three for using MongoDB is the free monitoring. So MongoDB, if starting with version 4.0 and higher, you can turn on a feature where your database is going to upload to the MongoDB cloud statistics about the database. And it will keep that information for 24 hours. So you'll have like a full 24-hour range of that data. And it doesn't only cover your database, but as you'll see, it will it also covers the system in general, like disk and CPU and stuff like that. So it can be very, very useful to monitor your server. Now, as a developer, this is really nice because there's some values that are super important that we optimize for. And one of them is the query targeting. Basically, this a high value indicates that the indexes in the database are not good. And so we request for a certain set of information from the database. And what happens is that the database does not have the indexes necessary to go and look up at these information and grab them directly. It needs to go one by one and eliminate some of the fields and accept some others. And obviously that slows down the operations of the database. So here, this is a very old screenshot that I have from maybe 2 years ago, where I had poor query targeting, and then I did an update with different indexes, better queries, and you can see that improved a lot. And the lower, the better. And so if you bring the query targeting to one or zero, then basically every query you make to the database, that MeshCentral makes the database knows exactly what to answer. It doesn't need to do one-by-one searches. So enabling the free monitoring is interesting. Now I'm gonna show how it's done. So I have my, demo server on the internet here, and I'm going to go mongo --. Version, and so this is a Linux MeshCentral server running on AWS, and I have currently Mongo 4.2 installed. And if I just type Mongo, enter, now this is a test server. I don't have access control in my database, which is fine because I block all the ports anyway, externally, so I just do loopback ports. But you'll notice that here it says free monitoring URI and the link, the URI to the free monitoring. And you're free to try to copy this URI here and take a look at it yourself. But by default, when you run MongoDB for the first time, it will tell you something different. It will say, well, we have this option for cloud monitoring, and type this command to enable it. Now, what you can do is you can also see here, I'm going to go to DuckDuckGo here, and you can type MongoDB free monitoring. And the first link here, free monitoring, is this is the documentation for MongoDB on how to turn on free monitoring. And it's basically db.enable free monitoring. That's the command. And you can disable it like this here. Okay, so once you've enabled it and you get the URI, anybody who has a URI, of course, can see that information. There's nothing too private in there, but I've already cut and pasted this URI here over here. And so let's take a look at what we have. So we have the time, the execution time for reading and writing on the database. We have disk utilization. So how often the disk is hit here, you know, we're at 1%. And so we're getting small spikes. Document returns, this is, you know, how fast are documents returned. And so, you know, not much except for some spikes here, like 200 documents returned per second, but mostly it's very, very low. And then memory usage, we have network input and output. And so you can see sometimes we hit spikes on our server, but mostly it's calm. And then counters, so we see that. And of course, there's a little eye here for information you can click to get more information about any one of these statistics. Query targeting is the one I personally use the most as a developer. And when you see these spikes, that's not good. Although they're occasional, so sometimes it's very rare queries, but you really want to have this value stick very, very close to zero all the time. And that means that you're making optimized queries and your indexes are really good. And let's see. And the last one here is CPU usage. So obviously, if the CPU usage goes up very high, this is something to worry about. And obviously, it's not just a database. If any process on your server starts using a lot of CPU, then you'll see this climb, and you can see that something is wrong. So it's not necessarily, even though this is a MongoDB free analysis tool, this is not exclusive. The CPU here is for all tasks, not just MongoDB. So hopefully that was clear. Basically, MongoDB is a great database choice for MeshCentral, and it should allow you guys to do server peering, to do very fast bulk operations to speed up your server, and also have free monitoring in the cloud. Thank you very much. Hopefully that was helpful.